There is an occult element at the high levels of society, and specifically among the Jews. So many of the people that are perpetrating the lies and the destruction on the country, they are evildoers. They are people that worship false gods. They are people that practice magic or rituals or whatever. And more than anything, those people need to be, when we take power, they need to be given the death penalty. Straight up. And I'm far more concerned about that than I am about even non-white people or mass migration. These people that are communing with demons and engaging in this sort of witchcraft and stuff, and these people that are suppressing the name Christ and suppressing Christianity, they must be absolutely annihilated when we take power. This is God's country. This is Jesus's country. This is not the domain of atheists or devil worshipers or perfidious Jews. This is Christ's country.
That is Nick Fuentes, a literal Nazi who also apparently believes in witchcraft, magic, demons, and all of that. He's out of his mind. I think that should be pretty clear from the video. And if he was just some random Nazi who, unfortunately, due to evolution and technology, could inflict on all of us his sociopathic incel ideologies, then that would be it. We wouldn't have to worry about it. But the issue is that that guy who is calling for the death penalty for everyone who isn't a Christian, including, by the way, and he focused on Jewish individuals during this time when the Republican Party likes to pretend that they're against anti-Semitism, is very well connected with Republicans historically, at least over the last few years. Remember, he's the guy who had dinner with Donald Trump and Kanye West. So that must have been a fun dinner. I wonder if they talked about demons or executing millions and millions of people. He also, of course, was hanging out with Marjorie Greene. Marjorie Greene, of course, spoke at an event that he founded and then pretended that she had no idea who he was, saying, "I am not going to play the guilt by association game in which you demand every conservative should justify anything ever said by anyone they've ever shared a room with. I'm not going to be drawn into that. I'm only responsible for what I say." Well, first of all, you didn't just share a room with him. You spoke at his event. It was his thing and you spoke there. But you're right. We shouldn't judge her based on the anti-Semitic comments of Nick Fuentes. We should judge her on the anti-Semitic comments she has made, including about space lasers. And again, it's not just them. You also have Paul Gosar, who speaks at those events too, white supremacist and Christian nationalist events. But he also had a staffer who was a big fan of Nick Fuentes as well. I don't know, maybe the staffer made the image of them murdering AOC and Joe Biden. So the issue isn't just that we have Nazi incels dreaming of the day when the vast numbers of Americans are gunned down by the state, but that he has an audience with these people. It's not impossible that he'll have another dinner with Trump, or that he could hang out with Vivek Ramaswamy, or that he could hang out with any of these people. So it concerns me as a person who would be on that death list. Adrienne, what do you think about it?
You know what? It's very concerning, without a doubt, that this individual has a platform, also that people continue to listen to them. And people who are leading in the Republican presidential campaign, like that's really, really terrifying. This thought that this is going to truly be a theocracy, when even though it has been low key for a bit, given that our money says in God we trust, but the thought that they're actually going to resort to slaughter if you don't believe what they want to believe. It's really scary, because we might even move even somewhat in that direction if Trump is elected president again. I don't know what to think other than the thought that the US has really gone off the rails, and it was not that great to begin with. It's a little tough.
Yeah, it's utterly insane that a person like this has an easier time accessing presidential candidates than academics, activists, all of that, utter madness.
And you know what? Something also, Nick Fuentes's ideology, it's not that far from kind of Stephen Miller's ideology. It might be different, but still the level and the degree to which they're willing to go. So by virtue of the fact that Nick Fuentes is foolish enough to say these things out loud, doesn't necessarily mean that there won't be someone else in Trump's administration who's willing to approach it in a more palatable way.
Yeah. By the way, you kept citing Christ there. I'm not an expert on theology or anything, but I wish that Jesus would come down So he would just body slam Nick Fuentes through the Earth's crust and mantle and straight into its core. Can you imagine? Can you imagine? God, these
guys.
I know. Utterly failed to live up to literally every standard, theological, physical, that they say they supposedly believe. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.